Joseph's going to start us off this hour from Washington, D.C. God help you, Joseph. How can we help?
Yes, thank you so much, sir. So COVID blessing, had an opportunity to kind of restart, reflect my finances. First time really ever did it in my life. My credit, you know, not where I wanted to be, like around 600. And encouraging my wife with the extra unemployment money that government was adding on, I put it towards, you know, paying off a lot of past debts, you know, hoping to have an increase, you know, the leverage to finally start making some things happen. Spent about $2,500, and I had a legal membership with Legal Shield. The attorney helped me, you know, negotiate and make some deals with creditors, and got it cleared off. You know, they're off the credit report. So here we go. You know, maybe we'll start seeing, get some traction, and I'm just disappointed. After 30 to 45 days, zero increase in the credit score, and I just don't know what else to do. What part of the game am I not seeing? What else should I be doing?
Well, Joseph, we're a little weird around the financial space because your credit score is something that we do not worship at. So the fact that your credit score is going down would be an issue, obviously, if you went to go buy a home and they pulled your credit score and it's not good, or you're trying to go get into more debt, then they pull the credit score. And if it's going down, obviously that's not good. But the credit score, we teach people to get out of debt. So actually, as you're getting out of debt, your credit score will lower. And within around 18 months, it becomes basically a non-issue because there's not enough information there to calculate. So long answer around is we don't really care about the credit score very much around here.
The reason is this, okay, Joseph. What we're trying to measure here is, and the way you're stating your question, is you're using the credit score to determine if you're winning financially. And it's not designed to do that. The algorithm that is built, that the FICO folks put together to build your FICO score, 100% of the mathematical variables that go into developing your credit score have to do with how you deal with debt. Okay?
Okay.
So
yeah.
Point being, if your family attorney called you after you got off the phone with us and said, hey, that uncle you never knew just left you $10 million, your credit score would not change one point, and yet you just got right. $10 million. So it's not a good indicator of financial health, because obviously your health would have increased. Or your boss called and said, you know, Joseph, you've been really kicking it. We're going to triple your income starting next week. It would not change your credit score one point. And so If you have assets, stuff, money, real estate, those kinds of things, and you have a great income, it does not affect your credit score. The only thing that affects your credit score is when you borrow and pay it back on time, the type of credit, how much credit. It's basically, mathematically, the truth is, it's an I love debt score. And so the reason we hate it around here is we hate debt. And so we want your credit score to be zero, because that means you have no debt and you have no interface with debt at all. And it's a false measure of whether you're winning. So a different way of looking at winning is this. Did you pay off a bunch of debt? Yes, you're moving into the winning column. When you did all that negotiation and you use that unemployment money, great job. Are you building up some cash for your emergency fund? Yes, check, you're winning. I think we're going to develop a Ramsey score that actually measures whether you're really winning with money or not, not just a debt score, okay? But that's the kind of thing that you're looking for, is you want to look at income and net worth and cash position. Your net worth is what you own minus what you owe. So if your debt's going down and your 401k is going up, you're winning. But that won't affect your credit score one point, except for the debt going down part. So what Rachel's referring to is, after you pay off all of your debts, you don't have a single debt anywhere, and all the accounts are closed, about 12 to 18 months later, your credit score will be zero.
Understood.
Mine's zero.
Well, it's not actually, well, it's,
and I'm a multimillionaire.
I do have a follow-up question.
Okay, jump
that
in.
I definitely want to
jump
listen.
In.
Well, because in my situation, I want to make sure, you know, I do agree with you. I hear you. I want to be out of debt. I'm starting from ground zero. My hopes and my credit score is just to qualify to get into a new apartment, or to be able to, access a new cell phone plan, just the basic building blocks of next step. Mm-hmm. And I was under the impression that, hey, you pay off your credit, they remove it from the credit score, equals a nominal increase, just so I can be a range of having access to.
Well, if you had an old bad debt and you cleared it within 3 to 6 months, you should see a bump, but it wouldn't be instantaneous.
Got you. So, okay, I'm just trying to get proper expectations.
Yeah.
I wasn't sure if I needed to start opening up one or two credit cards.
No, no, because the point is,
their game.
Yeah, no,
I don't want to be in debt.
Yeah, the point is, you don't want to go in debt so that later you can go into debt so that later you can go into more debt. It's a dog chasing its tail. So,
and Joseph, what you're saying, though, is correct. Like, if you go to rent an apartment, they sometimes will pull your credit score. If you, to get a new cell phone plan, they sometimes use that credit score. Insurance does as well. But here's the deal. There's ways around all of that. It takes time. It takes effort to get around each of those processes. But I've done it. And so what you have to do is you have to figure out, okay, what's another apartment that I can go rent? Or talking to the manager and saying, hey, I can pay first month's rent and last month's rent and cash here. There's ways around the system. And is it inconvenient at times? It is inconvenient, Joseph. I'm not going to lie to you.
But sure, if you're in the 500s and you paid off $30,000 worth of debt and you sit down and tell an apartment manager that, hey, I'm getting out of debt and that my credit score is low right now, but the reason it's low is I've been paying off this debt like crazy and I can show you where I paid off $30,000 worth of debt. If they won't rent to you then they're a no-brainer and you need to move away from them anyway. But most apartments will rent to you with a low or no credit score.
Yep, or an insufficient credit score is what it ends up being. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, zero. Yeah. So, hey, hang on. I'm going to send you a copy of the Total Money Makeover, which is the baby steps that we talk about, what to do first, what to do second, why to do it in that order, because it sounds like you're just getting started on all this stuff, and we want to give you a way of looking at it. You know, what's interesting, Rachel, is so much of the financial world is built around making banks richer. And, you know, the credit score is the greatest scam to have been placed because most people think like he thinks. They think, you know, I ran into a guy the other day. He's like, Dale, Dave, you're in the financial world? Yeah, my credit score is 780. And I went, God, I'm sorry. That probably cost you $100,000 in interest because it's about the, you got to make a lot of payments to get a 780 over a long period of time, on time. I mean, you got to screw around with a lot of debt to have a 780. And so that's cost you, I mean, it probably literally cost him $100,000 in interest.
Yeah, and I think people's mindset, when you shift to see that the financial industry, banks, credit card companies, all this, they're not caring about you, the person. They're making money. Like, they want to make money, and they make lots of money because
off of you.
And so you shifting that mindset to what the enemy is a good mindset to have.
You know what the interest rate on my credit card is?
Oh, I can't wait for the joke. What's the punchline?
Zero. I don't have one. But
okay. Oh, okay. I could have guessed that. Yeah. I thought there was going to be like I've charged up or something. I don't know.